Welcome to yet another challenge. More grunt work, not for the pretty boys that aren't ready to get dirty and complain about how long it's gonna take. That's why I'm here, because I have no problem doing that, because I'm a workhorse. I'm gonna get it done. I'm going to impress, and I'm gonna get a call back. Most important, as you've seen in the beginning, what we are up against. But the tools make the job easy, as I've said before. Always trying and willing to work smarter, not harder. Very cold day out here. Got the heater pumping just in case those hands get a little numb. No problem at all. Not too many things gonna stop us from getting this job done. White cars. Sometimes you might have to wash twice. Usually you get a white car customer because multiple car washes aren't gonna clean it after a while, which means it needs some hands-on loving. It's pretty simple. In the beginning, breaking down a lot of dirt, all-purpose degreasing the skirt if need be, throwing on that wheel brightener, heavy degrease on them rims, of course. Most white cars definitely want to have a clay bar handy, clay bar glove, make things easier during the wash. And as I buff right now, I may show a picture of it later in this video, but I'm using a microfiber waxing pad. It's gonna help dig a little deeper into that white paint to get that extra level of dirt off, to bring it back to a nice white shine. Also knock out a few scratches and paint transfer in the process. Easily made to look good. Nothing hard at all. The inside may look bad, but this is a grandfather. No one's in the car really, maybe some pets of course, but nothing too crazy. Old dirt, a lot of stains will come up or look a little better, but nothing's gonna come out showroom finished, which they understand and know. But it will come out looking much better and definitely impressive. You definitely wanna tackle the obvious stains, things that occur over time, such as the oils on the steering wheel, especially on the shift gear handle, and in the leather, concentrating on the driver's seat and the back seat if they have pets. Once again, you see that drill brush and air gun, you'd be crazy to try to vacuum this. Just have some type of brush handy, because it will definitely be needed. The seats are dirty from pets. Most of the stains will come up. Some stains will have to get a little aggressive, as you can see, but nothing too serious. Just have a good dilution of all purpose, and at times, a good amount of elbow grease. Keep in mind, many customers have never had a detail, and you are the first time to get to show an example of how it should be done, for if they ever want it again, or if they go to someone else and are disappointed. This is your chance. This is your first impression. Always remember that. Always keep that in mind. A family member may see it. You might not get a call back from the exact person, but the word could spread. Just like this customer. His granddaughter, I've done her car on multiple occasions, and she thought this would be great for her grandfather. And definitely, I'm sure he'll appreciate this. And keep in mind, this is grunt work. When you get into detailing, yeah, everybody wants the already clean cars, the BMW, Aston Martins, and all that. That will eventually come. But in the beginning, or if you decide to stick with it in the long run like I have, expect this. And I do. And I expect myself to have the tools and come prepared, because I know what I'm getting into. I know what I signed up for. Yes, I have the fancy exotic vehicle, customers and everything, but they're not going to be impressed as much as people who've had their first detail or can see their car go from ashy to classy. Got to take advantage of those moments, because that's the typical customer. The typical car owner has a Hyundai, has a Honda, has your typical everyday car, and it's going to get dirty because it's a commuter vehicle, not the weekend vehicle. If you aren't ready to get dirty or be able to acquire the supplies and the equipment that can give you a good job, then this definitely isn't the business for you. I enjoy the grunt work. I have no problem with it. Hard work is nothing. I know nothing else but to go hard and to put my best into everything I do, even if it was flipping burgers when I was a kid. I know nothing else. I like doing a good job, putting a smile on people's face, and this is the industry to be in. If you're a detailer, you already know this. Please like and subscribe. Any questions, comments, throw them right at me. Get back to you as quick as possible, and I'll see you soon. Once again, shout out to Camden, New Jersey.